Welcome back to Ruby on Nails, and this is my petition for a peppermint emoji, or at the very least, a candy cane. Due to popular demand and my inability to be creative, I'm recreating my recent Instagram post where I made candy-themed nails. Kicking this tutorial off, I'm using my favorite smoothing base coat by Holotaco in order to protect my natural nail and hide all the lumps and bumps. Because I want these nails to have a very candy-esque feeling, I'm using a shimmer jelly by Orly called Opening Night. While I don't feature Orly very often on my Instagram page, I'm actually a huge fan of their jelly formulas as they're surprisingly opaque. In just two coats, I was able to get a very beautiful base that complements the creams that I'm going to use later on in this video. I really love the slight shimmer that runs throughout Opening Nights. It's like a little secret between you and your nails. Up next, I'm going to show you some of the more technical things about this look. I'm going to be using Powered by Plants by Dimension Nails in order to do my first set of stripes. For my thick stripes, I'm going to be using a fairly short striping brush, as you can see here. This one's from Twinkled. While it might seem counterproductive to some, I'm using the short brush here because I can apply more pressure on the barrel of my brush, so that's the part where the paint is going to be coming off of. And the reason that this seems counterproductive is because a lot of people think that the shorter the bristle, the more in control you are of how thin of a line you can get. However, I find when I'm using nail polish and nail polish brushes, the longer and thinner the bristle, the less pressure I apply to the line overall. And that's how I'm able to get these really fine detailed lines that you're going to see in a little bit. For this particular set of lines that I'm creating right now, I want a thicker line. So that's why I'm using this short bristled brush, because when I apply pressure to the barrel of this brush, it's going to flare out to create a thick green line. If you have a method that works for you in freehanding straight lines, please keep doing that. I'm just sharing what works best for me. By the way, has anybody noticed how awesome this shade of green is? It's superb. Powered by Plants is a very creamy and opaque shade of green, and it's from a brand that I really, really love. Dimension Nails is cruelty-free, vegan, and tin-free, and they have a really great recycling program that I would suggest checking out. Okay, next up, I'm going to show you how I get those nice thin lines using a Twinkled white stamping polish, because I want something super opaque. This is the brush that I'm going to be using. It's also from Twinkled. For this particular step, I'm going to make sure that my brush is fully saturated. And as you can see, I'm applying very light pressure on the tip of this brush. This line's a little bit thicker than what I want because of how my camera was set up. I couldn't get the best possible angle. However, in this particular instance, you can see that the amount of pressure that I'm applying to this brush is very slight because of that nice long bristle. The next thing I want to point out to you is that when I am drawing on my line, I actually roll my nail away from the brush. This, I find, makes a straighter line. I don't know if it's just me, but this is what works for me. The last thing I'm going to point out about this particular candy-themed look is that I'm placing my white lines fairly sparingly. Because this look relies so heavily on these diagonal lines, I don't want to place too many too close to each other, so I'm very careful about how I'm spacing everything. My biggest suggestion when trying to mimic the pattern of anything, and in this case candy, is to pull up a reference image on your phone or device. I actually had one off to the side just so I could kind of mimic what I saw. While I suggest using a reference, you can definitely play around with this look, and it doesn't necessarily have to be Christmas themed. The only reason it's Christmas themed is because I chose red, green, and white. You could easily choose some pastels to make this a kawaii look too. And with that, you are done! It's time to seal it up with a top coat. Today, I'm using my new favorite by Glisten and Glow. When dry, this top coat has a very plush feel and is very high shine. And now you get to see how I changed this look up, so it's not exactly a match to my Instagram post. I paired this accent nail with some Mint Money by Holotaco, and I think this goes very nicely together. It's very glittery, it's very in your face, but it's kind of subtle and it doesn't take too much work because it is an accent nail. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, like this video, and if you like my videos, subscribe.